Hello students, welcome once again in the last lecture of the chapter Production and Cost. Today we will understand the different types of cost with their diagrammatic representation. First of all, we should know that the total cost of production is the aggregate of total fixed cost and total variable cost. Total fixed cost are those costs which are independent of the output. They do not change with changes in output. These costs are fixed, which are incurred by the firm in the short run. Even if the firm closes down for some time in the short run, but remains in business, these costs have to be borne by it. Therefore, fixed costs are also known as unavoidable costs. Fixed costs include such charges as rent, insurance, depreciation on the basis of time, property taxes, interest on capital employed, watchman's wages, etc. Graphically, total fixed cost will be represented as a straight line parallel to the horizontal axis. The curve shows that the total fixed cost remain constant at different levels of output. This curve starts from a point on y-axis, showing thereby that the fixed cost will be incurred even if the output is zero. I will like to tell you here that fixed costs are also known as general cost, supplementary cost or overhead cost. Second cost is total variable cost. Variable costs are those costs with changes in output. These costs include payments such as wages of labor employed, prices of raw material, fuel and power used, transportation cost, etc. If a firm shuts down for a short period, then it will not incur any variable cost. These costs rise as the firm's level of output increases. We can show it through a table. Here are two columns. First column is for units of output and second column is for total variable cost. Units of output are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and respectively total variable cost is 0 at 0 unit of output, 2000 at first unit of output, and we can see that total variable cost is increasing as we are increasing the units of output. Now if we draw a curve using this table, we get total variable cost curve. We can see that the total variable cost curve rises upward, showing thereby that as output increases, total variable cost also increases. This curve starts from the origin, which shows that when the output is zero, variable costs are also nil. Now, this total variable cost may be of different nature. On that basis, the total variable cost is of following types. First is completely proportional variable cost. This variable cost rises in the same proportion as the output increases. This curve will be a straight line upward sloping curve touches to the origin. Two columns, first for units of output and second for total variable cost. As units are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total variable cost is also 0, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500 and 600. Means as units of output are increasing in the same proportion, total variable cost is also increasing. Second type of variable cost is semi-variable cost. These costs are neither perfectly variable nor absolutely fixed in relation to the changes in the size of output. Example, electricity charges include both a fixed charge and a charge based on consumption. The curve of this type of cost will be like this. In this diagram, OF is fixed portion and above that is variable portion which increases with the increased consumption. Third type of variable cost is stair-step variable cost. These are costs which may increase in a stair-step fashion. That is, they remain fixed over certain range of output, but suddenly jump to a new higher level when output goes beyond a given limit. Example, fixed salary of a foreman will have a sudden jump if another foreman is appointed. when the output crosses a particular limit. The shape of cost curve in this case will be like this, showing that up to OA level of output, cost is constant. But it changes at the output OA1, but still constant up to the OB level of output, and the same way goes on. Now comes total cost. Total cost of a firm for various level of output are the sum of total fixed cost and total variable cost. Symbolically, total cost is equal to total fixed cost plus total variable cost. The total cost curve has been obtained by adding vertically the total fixed cost curve and the total variable cost curve. We can see that the total cost curve starts at the point from where total fixed cost curve starts, because at zero level of output also the total cost is equal to the total fixed cost. Now, the concept of average fixed cost. As we know that average means per unit, in the same way, average fixed cost is obtained by dividing the total fixed cost by the number of units of output produced. That is, average fixed cost is equals to total fixed cost upon Q. Q shows quantity of output. Thus, average fixed cost is the fixed cost per unit of output. Since total fixed cost is a constant amount, average fixed cost will steadily fall as output increases. Units of output are 0 to 6 and total fixed cost is 100 at each level of output. Now, if we calculate average fixed cost, formula will be 100 divided by 1, 100 divided by 2, 100 divided by 3, 100 divided by 4, and we will see that our average fixed cost is continuously falling. Therefore, if we draw an average fixed cost curve, it will slope downwards throughout its length but will not touch either axis, as average fixed cost cannot be zero. Next is average variable cost. Average variable cost is per unit variable cost. It is found by dividing the total variable cost by the number of units of output produced. Symbolically, average variable cost is equal to total variable cost upon Q, where Q is the number of units produced. Average variable cost normally falls as output increases from zero to normal capacity output due to occurrence of increasing returns. But beyond the normal capacity output, average variable cost will rise steeply because of the law of diminishing returns. The concept of increasing returns and decreasing returns have already been discussed. If we draw an average variable cost curve, it will first fall, then reach at its minimum and then rise. It is like a U-shaped curve. Now, the concept of average total cost. Average total cost is the sum of average variable cost and average fixed cost. That is, average total cost is equals to average variable cost plus average fixed cost. It is the total cost divided by the number of units of output produced. In the beginning, both average variable cost and average fixed cost fall. Therefore, the average total cost curve will also fall sharply. When average variable cost curve begins to rise, but average fixed cost curve still falls steeply, average total cost curve continues to fall. This is because during this stage, the fall in the average fixed cost curve is greater than the rise in the average variable cost curve. But as output increases further, there is a sharp rise in average variable cost, which is more than the fall in average fixed cost. Therefore, average total cost curve first falls, reaches its minimum, and then rises. Thus, the average total cost curve is also a U-shaped curve. Marginal cost. Marginal means additional. It is the addition made to the total cost by the production of an additional unit of output. In other words, it is the total cost of producing n units instead of n minus 1 units, where n is any given number. For example, if we are producing 5 units at a cost of rupees 200, and now suppose the 6th unit is produced and the total cost is rupees 250, then the marginal cost is rupees 250 minus 200, that is rupees 50. Now the marginal cost will be rupees 24 if 10 units are produced at a total cost of rupees 320, as it will be calculated by difference in total cost upon difference in units, that is 320 minus 200 upon 10 minus 5 units. It is to be noted that marginal cost is independent of fixed cost. It is only the variable cost which change with a change in the level of output in the short run. Therefore, marginal cost is in fact due to the changes in variable cost. Symbolically, marginal cost can be written as marginal cost equals to difference in total cost upon difference in number of units, or it can be written as marginal cost equals to total cost of n units minus total cost of n minus 1 units. Marginal cost curve is also a U-shaped curve due to law of variable proportions. Now, relationship between average cost and marginal cost. The relationship between marginal cost and average cost is the same as that between any other marginal or average quantities. The following are the points of relationship between the two. First is, when average cost falls as a result of an increase in output, marginal cost is less than average cost. Secondly, when average cost rises as a result of an increase in output, marginal cost is more than average cost. When average cost is minimum, marginal cost is equal to the average cost. In other words, marginal cost curve cuts average cost curve at its minimum point, that is its optimum point. Till now, we were discussing the short-run production function, and now it is the time to discuss long-run production function. In the long run, all inputs are variable. The total cost and total variable cost therefore coincide in the long run. Long run average cost curve is defined as cost per unit of output, that is, long run average cost equals to total cost upon quantity of output. Long run marginal cost is the change in total cost per unit of change in output. Long run marginal cost is equal to total cost at n units minus total cost at n minus 1 units. We have previously discussed the returns to scale. Now let us see their implications for the shape of long run average cost. During increasing returns to scale, as to double the output, input need to be increased by less than double, means output will be double but cost will increase less than double. So as increasing returns to scale operates, average cost falls as the firm increases output. Diminishing returns to scale implies that if we want to double the output, we have to increase the input more than double, thus causing the average cost rising as the firm increases output. Constant returns to scale implies that if we double the output, we have to double the input also, that is, the change in proportion of input and output remains constant, thus causing the average cost constant as long as constant returns to scale operates. Accordingly, long run average cost is a U-shaped curve, as initially increasing returns to scale operates, then constant returns to scale operates, and finally diminishing returns to scale operates. Let us check how the long run marginal cost curve looks like. For the first unit of output, both long run average cost and long run marginal cost are same. Then as output increases, long run average cost initially falls and then after a certain point it rises. As long as average cost is falling, marginal cost must be less than the average cost. When the average cost is rising, marginal cost must be greater than the average cost. Long-run marginal cost curve is therefore a U-shaped curve. It cuts the long-run average cost curve from below at the minimum point of the long-run average cost. We can understand it through a diagram. In the diagram, long-run average cost reaches its minimum at Q units. To the left of Q, long-run average cost is falling and long-run marginal cost is less than the long-run average cost curve. To the right of Q, long-run average cost is rising and long-run marginal cost is higher than long-run average cost. Here we have completed the concept of cost also. Our chapter, Production and Cost, completes here. Now we can do some questions to check our knowledge regarding this chapter. The first question is, the main function of entrepreneur is? Option A, production. Option B, innovation. Option C, investment. Option D, savings. The answer is option B, because the main function of entrepreneur is innovation. Second question is, which of the following is considered as production? Means, there are four options, you have to identify that one which is production in economics. First option is tilling of soil. Second option is teaching owns son at home. Third option is growing of tulsi plant at home. And fourth option is converting steel into a plate. Remember, production was creation or addition of utility. And this utility may be form utility, that may be time utility, that may be place utility, and that may be personal utility. So here our example is option D, converting steel into a plate. That is, we are converting the form of steel into a plate. It is generating form utility. Question number third is, marginal cost is equal to average cost at the first option, maximum of average cost, second option, minimum of average cost, third option, maximum of marginal cost, and fourth option, minimum of marginal cost. Remember the diagram that we have done. Average cost curve is U-shape and marginal cost curve is also U-shape. But where marginal cost curve cuts the average cost? Yes, it was at the minimum of average cost curve. So, our answer is B. Means marginal cost is equal to average cost at the minimum of average cost. Fourth question is, when total product is maximum, at that point marginal product is first option maximum, second option marginal product is minimum, third option marginal product is rising, fourth option marginal product is zero. Yes, our answer is D option, because when total product is maximum, at that point marginal product is zero. In this question, we are talking about law of variable proportions in the short run. Question number 5 is, law of diminishing returns is divided into dash stages. 1 stage, 2 stage, 3 stages and 4 stages. The answer is 3 stages. Our next question is, if marginal cost is 20 and average cost is 18, it means the position of marginal cost curve is below the average cost curve, touching to the average cost curve, parallel to the average cost curve, or above the average cost curve. See, in this question, marginal cost is 20 and average cost is 18. Means marginal cost is greater than average cost. And we have seen in the diagram, when marginal cost is higher than average cost, it means marginal cost is above the average cost curve, that is, answer is option D. So students, our chapter completes here. We will be here again with a new chapter. Till then, thank you.